It's Brian the Shaving Geek here. I've been wanting to do a video since I got back from the meetup on Friday, just to talk a little bit about my impressions and, you know, kind of my experience while I was there, and then also to kind of do an unboxing video and share some of the products that I picked up while I was at Pasteur's. First of all, Pasteur's itself is a phenomenal, phenomenal place. I was blown away by the amount of wet shaving products that they have there. Just totally, almost to the point of being overwhelmed. They have every, just about major English soap and cream that you can imagine. You know, they have so many wonderful, wonderful products there, from the Tabacs and, you know, down to the Arcos. You know, they have higher end products. They just, it's just overwhelming and unbelievable. I was totally blown away. But I was also very surprised at the prices there. Quite frankly, when I went, I didn't expect to buy too much. I made the assumption, we're in New York City, everything in New York is more expensive. We're three blocks from the Empire State Building, so that's going to add a premium. And it wasn't that way at all. They had some great prices, fair prices, and the people there are just phenomenal. The people that work there are very helpful and very gracious, and the owners are some excellent, phenomenal people, very, very nice. And so I was just totally blown away by that particular piece of the experience. But having said that, visiting there would be great by myself. But visiting there with 30 some odd people from around the world that had gathered in one place to just enjoy each other's company and to talk shaving and explore products was an epic, once-in-a-lifetime experience. And it was just unbelievable. It was so awesome to meet people that, you know, you've interacted with online, you've watched their videos, but to meet them in real life and just to realize that these people are just as awesome in person as they are, you know, in front of the camera or behind the keyboard, it was just phenomenal. And I'll name, you know, I'm not going to be able to name all 30 people, but it was great meeting every one of you. But just some of the highlights for me was, of course, meeting, you know, Anthony Esposito and meeting Busta. When Khan walked in, people didn't know that Khan was coming. When he walked in, and Pasteur's, you know, it's small. If you've ever been there, the aisles are rather tiny, but when Khan walked in, the place erupted. You know, it was just crazy. It was pandemonium, and it was so great to meet Khan. Meeting Jason Spiegelman and Chad Irish from the Shave Market was just phenomenal. Seeing Chris Williams again from the Shave Market, I met up with him about a year ago in Boston. It was great to see him again. And I spent, you know, quite a bit of time with Chris Cullen from Katie's Bubbles and, you know, had lunch with him. We went out for drinks afterwards. Just a phenomenal, great guy, and it was just a pleasure, you know, hanging out with you, Chris. Really, really enjoyed that. Ronnie Greer, just a phenomenal guy. It was so great having lunch with Ronnie and Peter Sharkalis. You know, phenomenal, phenomenal guys. It was just so much fun. And then in the evening, I actually, after, you know, things were kind of had wrapped up, we went out for some drinks. You know, there's, I think, five or six of us. Michael Teregiano, and if I'm butchering your last name, Michael, I apologize, but it was great hanging out with you. He had come up from Tennessee. He's got family that lives in New York, but traveled from Tennessee. Hung out with Nikki Smalls, who had come over from, I believe, Brooklyn. Chris Cullen went out with us, who had come up from New Jersey. And then Jorge Oviedo, I think is how you say your last name, spent time with him and his wife. Phenomenal, phenomenal people. It was just so much fun. And then I went out to dinner with Jorge and his wife to Times Square. We went to the Hard Rock Cafe, but it was really hard pop that they were playing. But we just had a great time. And folks, it was just so much fun. You know, 2 days later, and I think about it, and I get as giddy as a schoolgirl. which is pretty sad, but it, you know, it was fun. It was awesome meeting all of you. Billy T, Joseph Davids, Joe from Queens, just wonderful, wonderful people. And it was just, it was wonderful meeting all of you. And if I didn't say your name, that's not because, I didn't enjoy meeting you. I enjoyed meeting every single person that was there. You know, wish I would have been able to spend more time talking to more of you. The ones that I've named are the ones that I really spent more time chit-chatting with, but it was so much fun, and I just had a blast. It was a wonderful, wonderful time, and if you weren't there, you missed out on a great event. Now, on to the products that I picked up. I didn't, you know, really go with an agenda of I want to buy this, I want to buy that. I just wanted to go touch, see, feel, and obviously smell these products. And there were just so many wonderful, wonderful things that were there. But there were a couple that just jumped out at me, some things I was looking for. You know, I really didn't go with the idea of buying any more soaps. I've got 40 some odd soaps, and, you know, there's a few more that I'm planning on buying, but I'm not planning on buying, too many more soaps in the near future. I've been adding to my aftershaves, though, and when I smelled this, I knew I was buying it. I knew I was bringing it home. I've seen this out there, and quite frankly, just looking at it, I didn't think I was going to like it. Now, I love sandalwood. I love bay rum. My understanding is that Captain's Choice, everything has got a base of bay rum. Like I said, I love sandalwood. I love bay rum. I didn't think I was going to like the two of them together. How wrong I was. Woo! This is awesome, awesome stuff. I am telling you, folks, this is phenomenal stuff. Woohoo! That is just great, great stuff. TSC, you're right. This is awesome sauce. Love it, love it, love it. Very glad to have that in my den. So happy to pick it up. You know, the other thing I was really blown away by at Pasteur's, I think I may have mentioned this earlier, is I was impressed. The prices were very good. You know, $18 on this, very, very fair price. And no complaints. Good, good stuff. Glad to have it. I also picked up German Street by Tobbs. Now, I picked up some German Street. Do I have that upside down? I had that upside down. I picked up some German Street Balm in a trade, I think almost a year ago. And I have been wanting to get the German Street Tobbs shaving cream since then. And so I saw it there, and I just said, you know what? I'm here. I might as well pick it up. I might as well buy it. And so I did. And I really, really love this scent. Woo! That is just a very, very classy, in my opinion, it's a little cologne-y, but I just really, really love this scent. It's got a very refined scent to me, and I really, really enjoy it, and so glad to have it. I also picked up some blades that I've been wanting to try. I picked up some Pole Silvers. I've heard a lot of people talk about these. And then I picked up some Rapira Super Stainless. I've heard people talk about these as well. I'm very interested to see how the two are going to compare to each other. Because as you can see, this blade, a pack of 5 cost me $2.49. On this blade, a pack of 10 cost me $1.79. So I'm going to be interested to see how the two compare and whether or not the Pole Silvers actually are worth the premium price. But just very excited to try those out. I also picked up some Gillette Silver Blues. Love those blades. They're my go-to blade, and I had run out of them, so I wanted to pick some up while I had the opportunity. The last thing I picked up was some Tea Tree Mustache Wax. And this, I believe, is by a company called Beard Brand. To be honest with you, I wasn't going to pick up some mustache. I saw they had a couple. They didn't have a big selection of mustache wax. But I had talked to some people online, got some feedback with regards to mustache wax. And so I had talked to Jorge, and he recommended Dubs. But the scent on this was just so great. I was like, let me give it a try. It's tea tree, peppermint, and vanilla. And I love the scent on this. I use it today. And the performance, just compared to what I've been using with my, I have the Clubman, it wasn't all that great. You can see it's very floppy, and With a Clubman, I apply it once in the morning, and it lasts all day. This just doesn't have the hold. Don't know if I didn't use enough. I need to play around with it. But as far as performance-wise, I can't say that I love this. But, you know, I was happy to give it a shot, and, you know, no complaints. So, anyhow, guys, I know this has gone long. I wanted to go shorter than this, but it was such an epic day. There's no way I can just... It was awesome. That's all I can say. It was great meeting all of you guys and ladies as well. Got to meet Susan and the Stallions' lovely lady and Jorge's wife, who's just an absolute phenomenal lady. Wonderful, wonderful people, all of you. And, you know, I love you guys and gals. It was great meeting you in real life and looking forward to meeting up with you again in the near future. So this is Brian, the Shaving Geek, reporting live from my shave den. Still excited about Friday's events and wishing you a lifetime of happy shaves. Have a great day, everybody. Hey, guys, there's a little bit of an addendum or a PS I guess I want to add to this video. Normally, I do my videos in one take. I don't really edit them, splice them together, or anything like that. That's just how I prefer to do it. But I did leave out one person that I really didn't want to when I was kind of talking about the people that I was really excited to meet, and that was Claudio Portugal. Claudio, it was awesome to meet you in real life, man. Foi prazer grande para mim, and it was just very, very awesome to meet your family and your wife, your son. Again, this, I don't want anybody who, if I didn't mention your name in particular, I don't want you to feel left out, but because it was great meeting everybody. But Claudio was the one that kind of set this thing all up, got the ball rolling. And I just wanted to say, obrigado, Claudio. Foi grande prazer. And one day I'm going to meet you in Brasilia, okay? So, ciao, and thanks, everybody. Take care.